Welcome. In this video, we'll see the memory organization of 8051. So as we know that there are two types of memories in 8051. One is ROM, which is used for storing the program or code memory, and the other one is RAM, which is used for storing the temporary data. So the capacity of ROM is 4 kilobytes in 8051, and the capacity of RAM is 128 bytes in 8051. So the RAM memory is divided into different sections. So this is the first section that is called as general purpose registers. Then next section is bit addressable RAM. Then the third section is a scratchpad RAM, which can be used for any general purpose data transfer. And finally, we have a section which is used only for the SFRs. So the address starts from 00 hex to 7F hex. So these are total 128 byte locations in RAM memory. Then the addresses from 80 hex to FF hex are dedicated only for the SFRs. So all the memory locations in this sections are not accessible. Only the locations for which the SFRs have addresses, only those locations are accessible. So this is the layout of on-chip internal RAM. So this is the first section that is called as general purpose registers. So these registers are again divided into different subsections. These subsections are called as banks. So the number of locations in this general purpose registers are from 00 hex to 1F hex. So total 32 locations are there. So each bank is having 8 general purpose registers, and these registers are having names as R0 to R7. So every bank are having the same registers, that is R0 to R7 for each bank. Then these registers can be or these banks can be selected with the help of two bits which are present in PSW register. So these bits help to select any one bank out of these four banks. So depending on value of PSW.2 and PSW.3, we can select any one out of these four banks. Next section is bit addressable RAM. So in this again, the memory locations which are there in RAM, those are bit addressable. It means that we can access the individual bit instead of the entire byte. And that bit addressable section starts from 20 hex to 2F hex address locations. So as you can see that individual bits are also going to have the bit addresses. So starting from this, that is 20 hex location, it is going to have 8 bits. So first location is going to have address as 00 hex, and last location is going to have address as 07 hex, and so on. So in this way, this bit addressable memory also has the individual bit addresses. So the starting address is 20 hex to the final address is 2F hex. So this is bit addressable RAM. And the last part of the RAM location is the general purpose RAM. So this general purpose RAM starts from address 30 hex to 7F hex. So in this, the locations are byte addressable. It means that we can access the entire byte, and this can be used for any general purpose operations. Next is the bit addressable RAM. Again, this is part of the SFRs, which is having address from 80 hex to FF hex. So 80 hex is the starting address and FF is the final address. So in this, again, only SFRs are present, and these SFRs are having some special functions which are used to control the peripherals or which are the data SFRs. So again, some of the SFRs are bit addressable, whereas some of the SFRs are byte addressable. So the SFRs which are having individual addresses, bit addresses, only those SFRs are bit addressable, whereas the other SFRs are not bit addressable. So we have to access the entire byte of that SFR. So the special function registers are of two categories. First one is data registers, and second one is control registers. So data registers are the registers which are just used for storing some value or some data. So the example of these data registers are the accumulator, the B register, then all the port registers, right, and so on. So the next category is the control registers. So these control registers are the registers or SFRs which are used for configuring the peripherals which are present in 8051. For example, for timer has some SFRs like TMOD and TCON, which can be used for configuring the timer. Similarly, serial ports are going to have some special function registers, as well as interrupt system is going to have some SFRs for configuration. So these SFRs have addresses from 80 hex to FF hex. So this is the memory map which shows the different SFRs present in 8051. So this is the, for example, accumulator, which is having address as E0 hex. Then B register is having address as F0 hex, and so on. So all the SFRs which are there in this memory map, those SFRs are present in 8051. And all the SFRs which are present in this first column are the bit addressable SFRs. Means we can access the individual bit of that SFR. Whereas the remaining SFRs are not bit addressable, we have to access the entire 8 bits of that SFR. So this is about the SFRs and the memory organization of 8051. Thank you.